Hello everyone, this is Dr. Audrey Tai. Welcome back to my channel, Eye Channel by Eye Surgeon. In today's video, I would like to share with you about my experience of getting the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine. I've listed down below of the time codes of this video to help you guide through the different parts of this video. I'm really grateful to be among one of the healthcare workers who were able to receive our first dose of COVID-19 vaccine back in December of 2020. I want to give a big shout out to all of the healthcare workers who are working tirelessly both in the hospital as well as in the vaccine clinic for making this project possible. The Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine received emergency use authorization from the FDA on December the 11th of 2020. So within a week after the Pfizer vaccine received emergency use authorization from FDA, I received a notification from Mission Hospital in Mission Viejo, California, that I was prioritized to receive the vaccine. I was assigned to a vaccination station. At the station, I was presented with a few paperwork letting me know some possible physical symptoms I may develop after receiving the vaccine. After I reviewed all of the paperwork, I received my vaccine in my left arm around the deltoid region, and it was a really nice shot. I barely felt the needle. After receiving my vaccine, I stayed for about 15 minutes or so after the vaccination to make sure that I didn't develop any acute allergic reaction before I was discharged. So I received my vaccine around 9 o'clock in the morning. For the 6.5 hours after that, I didn't really have any symptoms. However, around 3:30 in the afternoon, I started noticing there's some soreness in my left arm. And gradually throughout the afternoon and into the evening, the soreness in my left arm extended to the left side of my neck. I would say the stiffness in my neck as well as soreness in my arm, they peaked around midnight. During the night, I woke up a couple of times and noting significant neck stiffness and arm soreness. I was prepared to take some Tylenol or even Advil if the stiffness and pain persist, but I was able to fall back asleep. In the morning when I woke up, most of the arm pain and neck stiffness have improved. However, it was still quite noticeable. I was actually quite glad that I didn't have any cases in the OR that day. Throughout the second day after my vaccination, by the time the evening comes, the arm soreness and neck stiffness mostly went away. So it's very interesting. I never developed any fevers or chills or other symptoms reported by the vaccine recipients in the clinical trial. Everybody's different. So when you get your COVID-19 vaccine, you may develop similar or completely different type of physical symptoms. I look forward to hearing from your experience in the comments down below. So it has been about 3 weeks since I received my first dose of Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine. I didn't really develop any new physical symptoms since the arm soreness and neck stiffness subsided the day after my first vaccination. I'm actually scheduled to receive the second dose of my vaccine tomorrow. Because I developed significant arm soreness after the first dose, I blocked off my schedule after my second dose of vaccine to make sure I'm not operating the day after receiving my second dose of Pfizer vaccine. I received the second dose of the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine during the second week of January, about 3 weeks after I received my first dose. And during that 3 weeks, I didn't really experience any additional physical symptoms. For my appointment for my second dose of the vaccine, I arrived a few minutes before my appointment time. My vaccination appointment went quite smooth from the second dose of my vaccine, very similar as when I received my first dose. I completed a check-in process and I was assigned to a vaccination station. I completed some paperwork there, and Nurse Susan gave me my second dose of the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine. The actual injection was painless, and we were both very excited because now I have completed my two doses of the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine, so now I'm fully protected. I waited about 50 minutes after receiving the vaccine to make sure that I did not develop any allergic symptoms before I was discharged. And for the rest of the day, I actually worked a regular schedule. I saw patients in the clinic for the whole day, It was very interesting. I actually didn't notice any pain in my left arm where I received the injection for the whole day. Started 9 o'clock in the evening, I started feeling feverish and I started getting some chills. I actually had a low temperature fever of 101.1 and I checked my O2 saturation, which was normal. I was a bit tachycardic. I had a bit of fast heart rate and I felt really tired. So I went to bed early. And throughout the night, I actually didn't sleep well because of the fevers and chills that I was having. I actually felt pretty cold throughout the night. When I woke up in the morning, now it's about 24 hours after I received the second dose of my vaccine, I had a headache throughout the whole day. I felt really tired and I pretty much spent the whole day on the couch. I was really glad that I took the day off the day after I received my second dose of the vaccine, because I just felt so tired the whole day. I wasn't productive at all. I pretty much just did some paperwork, some computer works on the couch throughout the whole day. And I went to bed really early, around 7:30 in the evening, because of the fatigue that I experienced. And I also had some muscle achiness. It was interesting because this time I had the muscle ache in both of my legs. I didn't have much of arm pain around the injection site. So after I woke up in the morning, now it's about 48 hours after I received the second dose of vaccine, all my symptoms were gone. Actually, I felt like nothing has happened. All of the physical symptoms I was experiencing the day before, they resolved completely. To summarize, after I received the first dose of my Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine, I actually had pain in my left arm as well as the left side of my neck for about 36 hours after receiving the first dose of the vaccine. And after I received the second dose of my vaccine, I experienced more intense physical symptoms. I had fevers, chills, fatigue, muscle ache, and headaches, which were all common physical symptoms reported in the clinical trial. However, all those symptoms actually resolved spontaneously after 48 hours after I received my second dose of vaccine. So all the physical symptoms that I experienced, as well as the physical symptoms reported in the clinical trial, those are actually common physical symptoms that people may experience after having an activation of their immune system due to the inflammatory response from it. There's a scientific term describing those physical symptoms. It is called reactogenicity, which covers the group of physical symptoms that can occur shortly after receiving vaccination due to the immune system activation and the inflammatory response comes with it. So it is expected after receiving the COVID-19 vaccine for you to experience some physical symptoms, as that's basically a sign the immune system of our body is working and is actively producing antibodies to protect ourselves against future infection. If you have already received your COVID-19 vaccine, I would love to hear about your experience in the comment area down below. It is very important to remember the COVID-19 vaccine is effective to protect us against getting sick from getting the COVID-19 disease if we're exposed to the virus in the future. However, it does not protect us from getting infected by the virus or carrying the virus, even potentially spreading the virus into the community. So even after receiving the vaccine, we still have to practice social distancing and wearing masks to prevent spreading of the virus into the community. It is also very important to remember, make sure that you discuss with your physician if you have any specific questions about your health and your eligibility receiving the COVID-19 vaccine. When the COVID-19 vaccine becomes available to you, and if you do not have any medical condition contraindicated to receive the vaccine, I hope you would consider getting the vaccination yourself. This is how we all do our part to protect our community, family, friends, and colleagues. I hope after watching this video, you're able to find answers to some of the questions or concerns that you may have about the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine. If you find this video helpful and you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up. And consider subscribing to my channel and turning on the notification bell down below so you won't miss any new videos I make about eye health and medicine. Thank you again for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video.